Hello, dear friends. This is Jean-Pierre speaking. I'm giving you today other new tips about the stretching class and the proportional gym, which are going to be very easy. This stretching that we are going to do today, you have to do it after very good warm-up. Don't do it when your muscles are cold. So you absolutely need to do a good warm-up stretching before of your own, and then you can add some of the exercises that I'm going to do today. There are two ways to do this kind of stretching. Is one that I already explained in my previous videos, but I usually use this one, which is sort of, it's not elastic, it's just like a cord, and it has a different circle that I use around the waist and also onto the feet. And there is another one which is the famous elastic band, which is in between the soft one and the strong one. So it depends how my body feels, because there are some days which my body feel very supple, very elastic, and there are some days in which I feel more stiff. So I have to handle the situation without pushing, without doing any harm to my muscles, to the lumbar, to the hips, to the spinal cord, and so you have to go very, very carefully of what to do. And the only person who can tell you what to do or what not to do, it's you, it's not me. So I'm just giving you some tips, some advices, and if you think there is something good that you could apply for you take it and you are most welcome. If you see that the advices I'm giving you are not good, then just leave them completely aside. So today we are going to try to work with this one. I'm not going to push too much because I'm not fully stretched, so I'm just showing you and giving you some explanation. So I just put the last circle in around my foot and put it around the waist. So you see there are two colors. Of course, in the black and white video you only see one color, I think. So the light, when you keep one color on the inside part of the body, and the other color must go outside. Then you choose the distance. You can choose this one, you can choose the last one, or you can choose the shorter one, which goes for the length of your leg when you are going to stretch. Of course, I would suggest you to choose the middle way. So in order that you don't push too much, especially if your body is not warm enough. So this is very good also for the back. And so put this here on the inside and just bend the head forward. And I go backwards and I push backwards. So with my feet, I push my feet forward and I arch a little bit my back and I stretch my elbows. And you do that as many times as you wish. You know, you have to feel that your body, which is already warm, But you will feel that your backbone will become more loose, more elastic. Okay, so now I'm going to change position because I want to show you what I'm going to do. Let's talk a little bit of the front. I'm going to do this and just keep my knees well stacked, and then just point my feet and I flex. I point and flex. And point and flex. And point and flex. You can do that as many times as you want. So it's going to pull the muscles of your feet as a part. So you oblige your feet to be well pointed and well arched, and it fights first underneath your feet, the flat of the foot. But the back column has to stay straight. Then, on the dot, on the dot, on the dot, on the dot. And you do that as many times you want. Then, with a rotation, you try to point your foot each time. But actually, you are pulling your back. You're not working with your feet. You're working more with your back than with your feet. And you keep your stomach muscles in. Pull in all the way during this exercise. And this is also very good for the upload. And bend a little bit the knee and point. Bend and point. Then I flex the feet and I point the feet in it. And bend and point. And bend and point. And then, and just go down. Now, I'm going to turn this way. I don't know if you're going to be able to see the whole thing. Just in the video camera, I have to do it on fast, but on fast is not good. I'm going to show you that my work time is not long enough to however, you will understand the idea. So, once you are here, you just open, and you keep your knees well stretched all the time, and you close. Open, and close. You see, I just keep the turn out, just keep an eye on my feet, you see that my feet are open, they are not closed, they are on the hole. So I just keep this on the hole with a stretch knee possibly, a stretch knee all the way during this exercise. And while I do this, I keep my foot up, my torso well pulled up, and I keep all the strength with my arms sideways. So actually, with my arms, I'm cheating because I'm just giving the full strength. I'm reducing the strength of my stomach and I'm pulling more with my arms. You do that 8 times or 16 times, but very, very slowly, in order that your inside muscles, they start to get warm up. Now from here, I just go there, and I bring my arms well pulled up to the torso as well. And I do the same thing without touching the floor. So this is a little bit more difficult. One. Two. And three. And four. And five. And six. Seven and eight. You can do another, and you can count in a different way. And one. And two. And three. And four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. So in case you might feel some pain here in the back, then you stop completely. You can have pain in the legs, you can have pain in the shoulders, you can have pain in the feet, you can have anywhere, but never in the back. When you feel some pain in the back, then you stop. Don't do it. So, like that. Just do a simple exercise of the arm in order to breathe. Just close. And open. And close. And open. And you do that 4 times, 8 times. In order that you test also, like when you do the bar, that you do a retrieve, and you stay in a flow, and here is the same thing. You stay in a flow. Why do you do this? In order that you don't lose the balance. You do that 8 times. Then you change, you make a little photograph on the side, a little photograph on the side, and you can do that 4 times or 8 times, it depends how you feel and how is the state of your body. Okay, now you have finished with this. You put only one arm in the middle, that's it, on the floor. And the feet, the tight to join the 2 feet, but one must go underneath the other. You see? It's like if I do a 5th position, reflex foot. Then I open, then I change, I put the other foot underneath, and I change. I change, and you do that 4 times, not more. So you give the stand here, the shoulders and the torso as well, open. And I just go slowly, slowly. One. And I open. And I change. Two. And I open. And three. You see my feet are flexed and turned out when I do the 5th position. And I open. Now, I can change the arm very slowly. But I have to show well the position of the arms before going down. So now I do 4 again in 5th position, with flex feet. 5th and 4. 5th and 4. And 5th and open. And 5th and open. Now, I just bring the 2 arms together, so I just have to cross the 2 wrists together on the floor. Don't do that. Just cross. Why? Because I'm going to join the 2 legs, so if I keep that open, the legs will not be able to join. I have to cross, you see the line here and the wrist. This is the place where the legs are going to join. So I'm going to do one, and I open, and two, and I open, and three, and I open, and four, and I open, and five, six, seven, eight. If you don't feel to make eight, you make four. Then from here, I just turn and repeat. So you might feel that race is going to slide down in the middle of the back. It's not a problem, but sometimes you have to pull it up. So to pull it up, you just use your elbow. So I just do that. And stretch and leave. And stretch and leave. And stretch. And this you can do as many as you want. There is no danger that you might have an accident. And breathe. And stretch. And breathe. And stretch. And breathe. And when I stretch, I just point to well the feet and on below the legs. And keep the torso well open. And breathe. And stretch. And three. Now, if I do the same thing with mouth in arms, I just do. First, I take the position with the head. Boom. Just pull my arms, and I do. And one. And two. And you see, this is what I meant in the other video, that my legs look like the old TV antenna of 1980 and 1975. You know those old TV that we had on the table and they had the antenna going like that? Those are exactly like my legs now. And you do 4 or 8, but I prefer you do 8 or 8. Now here, I just put my two hands, on this level, and I flex my feet, and I do 1, 2, 3, 4. Just a little balance. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now, I just stand on one side, I lean on one side, I keep this very well set, and I do 3, and stretch. 3, and stretch. 3, and stretch. And 3, and stretch. This foot must be very well flexed, and actually you are pulling, it's not you, it's your pulled foot who is pulling the flexed foot here, the opposite way. And change, and lean a little bit, and create, and fold. Create, so this is the point, and this is the flex. So it's the point who is pulling into the flex one. Lee and lee and lee and lee. For this you can do 8 and 8 one more time. So now, here, I just curve my spinal cord and I release everything and I exhale. And I inhale and I exhale. Now, when you inhale your tea, try to do it with your nose, not with your mouth. You do it with your mouth when you are too tired. But with the nose is much better. Now try also to not breathe. From one hand is not elegant, from the other is is not productive for the movement. Here, just see, I'm pushing my two arms on, but okay, and I'm slowly, slowly going down, not pushing. If I feel that I'm not supple enough, I'm not pushing too much, I'm just going, letting go, letting go. As I said, there are some days in which you feel very supple, and there are some days where you feel more close, more tight. So you mustn't push. This is something that happens to all ballet dancers and to all human beings. So you have to be reasonable and not push too much. And you can do that 8 times. There are dancers who stay like that. And they stay. So this is also very good. They stay, you need to relax all the muscles, all the tendons. You can also not give any pressure to your feet, just leave them half point, half thrust, and you just relax all of the foot. So this was one exercise. Now, in the previous video, I've shown you that I was working towards the bed, putting my feet next to the bed. Now, I'm going to do the same thing in a very simple way, in order that I don't take too much time for the video, without the bed, and I'm going to use all these. I'm going to show you on the bed. So, the important here is that you make an attitude with this foot, with this leg, and you put this thing in front, not back, and this must be well positioned in the middle of the back, and very simple, you just go a little bit on the side and you let go of the body. If you feel some pain, you have to get used to it. And you relax the whole body until you feel that the pain is gone. Don't stand up before. Open. And breathe and change. Now, the important thing is this leg, which must be possibly well spent. Now, it may happen that the means will then be complete. Now, if you see that you cannot go any further, you just stay like that. Otherwise, you just let it go. See, today, I'm not feeling fully stretched, so I don't want to push too much. Now here, this is a little bit more difficult, so you mustn't pull. You go forward and you put your hands and you just go down. So while you do that, this is flexed, and while you go down, you just point your foot and you keep that in attitude. And you do that 4 times. Then you change. Now be sure that while you do this exercise on the side, that your legs doesn't slide forward. Always keep an eye on the corner of your eyes, that the underarms will always work properly. As soon as you see that one of the 2 legs going forward, just pull them again. As all dancers, we all have a part of the body which is more elastic, more supple, more loose than the other. Like the dancers who are left turners and right turners, and we always have a part of the body which works a little bit better than the other. So you mustn't be scared or worried. If you see that from one side you cannot reach the extension, from the other you can. So, you must be very patient. I do that. I'm going to do that four times. Now we have been doing with this, with this knee. Now we do with the two knees. Always check the depth. Let go with it. Just relax. And you breathe. Let a deep breath between one movement and the other. You can do that four times or eight times. Now here, with the two knees in attitude, you go and you bring forward. And you try to point, with two feet. You try. That is very good. Bend this. Now this is only for people who have already 3-4 months or maybe more work and they got used to this thing. For people who are starting, especially for another non-professional, you mustn't do that. For dancers, they can try to do that. When I use the elastic, it's very good for elastic, but the elastic helps you to cheat a little bit, while this one, which is stronger, doesn't permit you to cheat. So you must pull, you must work very hard on this, so you feel that your muscle is pulling all the way through and that you have to pull forward, pull out, and pull up, and all the muscles all together, and you feel some pain while you are working. So you must be very patient and never go fast in this part that I'm going to do. So, wait, I made a mistake. Have to make it shorter. You see, my foot was here, now I made it a little bit short. So you can start doing 8 or 16 times slowly, bending attitude and knees stretch, bend, knees stretch. And you test your balance with your arms. If you can take off your arms from the floor while you do that. Now when you see that your balance is well in the middle, you just open and you put your arms. Now with your arms, you see I'm just pushing my underarm a little bit more, stretching my elbows. from the spleen, and I'm stretching the elbows as well. Plie, and I stretch maximum I can. And I stretch, and I keep my body well pulled up. And you do that 8 times or 16 times. So slowly, slowly, adjust your and you do that as many times as you want. Just to test the balance, and then breathe. Good. Now, this is the part that I was telling you before. You stretch this foot, and this one stays in attitude. You see? So the knees go a little bit more up. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to put your hand here, so it goes actually on this side, not even on this side. I put it on up, and I just open. Breathe, and open. Breathe. When I open, I will feel some pain. Now I'm feeling some pain now, actually, but I have to resist until I get used to the pain. It hurts, almost. Even if I am in excellent condition, it always hurts a little bit. So, it's like when you are at the bar, the same feeling. It's like when you are at the bar and you are doing an écarté, see? Developing écarté. You see, the first two are painful, then you get used to it. Tomorrow morning when I would wake up, it's going to be and then I'm just okay. Now there's another movement that you can try to do. So that was on one leg and on the other leg. Now I just put this and I put that in here. And I bend this foot and this one goes as a woman. So the important here is that this knee must stay sideways with the shoulders here. Now this is like developing a capté that you do in the passé, that you do at the bar or in the center. So same feeling, same look that you must have. How to say? You understand. You don't need I talk too much. So. You try to test your balance while you are here. Now you change your arm. You go a little bit down. You try to touch the other foot and you go up. That was one part. Now, do that. So, if you know why you do that, you see that the second circle is too tight. You can try to make the first circle, which is like that. You always have a try, and you see which one is better for you. But never go too tight in the beginning, just go gradually. And this was one exercise. Now this is another form of exercise that I said before, with an elastic. The most difficult thing is to put the elastic on the foot and around the waist. Can we have a try in this way? Let's see if I can manage. adjust the elastic with your elbows. So now this is good for the feet. Make a point. You flex. A little bit flex, lower back, as I get used to the pain. So here, just put the towel. For the beginners, we can use this kind of pillow when we put it on the floor. Why? Because now when you will try to go forward, the elastic is going to push you down. So if you don't know how to handle the situation, you knock your mouth on the floor and you end up to the dentist and you have to change all the teeth that you have in front. So with this, it makes a sort of security airbag in the floor to avoid the accident. If you know how to handle a situation, then you just use your towel. So I would suggest you to do this. Open well the torso and put your two arms in front. You just put your elbows sideways, go down. Sideways, now putting your head and you stretch and lean in and you stretch, lean in and you stretch and lean in and you stretch. You do that 4 times, 8 times. Then you make plié with only one elbow. Knee. Stretch. Knee. Stretch. You see, I bring your elbow sideways, not next to my leg. Knee. Side. Knee. Sideways. And I just return in order that my knees go back. Now here I just bend one knee and stretch. Bend. Keep an eye that the knee must go behind, mustn't fall to the front. And try to lift it as much as you can. So you will feel some pain here, don't worry, it's very low. See, this is, those are the kind of movements that are consuming my ballet shoes and that made the beautiful holes in the heel. Okay, now with this I have finished and just try to put my palms away I'm going to just go slowly. So I'm not fully stretched today. I'm not going to push too much because I feel some pain in my back. So I'm just let go. And I help with my palms. Just go. I don't want to push too much today. The thing is that when you are 62 years old, a bit older, your body unfortunately is imposing, is setting you some rules that you have to follow. And all that dancers, me included, we are all stubborn and we don't want to accept that. We want to prove to ourselves that we can still work and that we can. We must never give up. Never give up and just work and work and work and work and work. And you must always remember the same thing. If you are the ballet dancer, you are the ballet dancer. Even if you are a retired one, even if you are a ballet teacher, you have been a ballet dancer. So you must never give up. If you want to teach well, you have to train your body. Because otherwise your body cannot show the movement, cannot demonstrate anything to the students. So you have to keep in a good shape. So I'm just doing this the last time. So there's another exercise which is killing you and kills me as well. Just put my arms backwards and I turn a little bit the arm here and I put my arm back and just go down. And I try to put my ear on the floor. That movement is killing you. Can you do that 4 times? There are a thousand of other little exercises that you take, the elastic, you go sideways, then you stay, and then you go the other side, and you keep the elastic, or without elastic, you just put your hand on the floor, or you just make a rotatoire, a rotation on the door, and if you are able, you just go forward and backwards, and you know, there are a thousand of exercises. Now I'm just showing you the essential one. I don't want to kill you and I don't want to kill you as well. So here, you can see me, just go down and just let go of the legs. Alles so gut. Und dann just relax. Just relax. Without even any step. you have been doing so much effort before, so now you need some relax. Because I will need it for other movements that we are going to do in the next part. So for today, it's enough. And in the next video, I'm going to show you how to do some movements that will help you with the stomach overflow for the combo. Now, as you may know, not many people have a good combo. I am one of them. So my combo is not perfect because also I had an accident in my back. So I have to take very care, and I have to be to do a very good warm up before recording the video in order that I don't make a terrible figure. And the next video that I will show you, I'm going to do all this routine. For today, thank you very much.